Sweet World, starters here, Skeets, Tass, Trey, and Lee. The 2016 NBA All-Star Game has just ended. People filing out of the Air Canada Center. We got to get going here because All-Star Weekend is officially over, Tass.
We had a lot of incredible moments, so let's just get this started. Here is the best of the starters from 2016 All-Star Weekend.
As we're competitive junkies, we had to make a challenge, which is why we are starting the Canada Cup. Canadian-themed events, guys. We're going head-to-head in this. We did one today. It's probably the most Canadian thing of all. It's an ice skating competition.
Oh, all right.
2, 1, go.
Okay.
And
there goes Tass.
There you go.
Around a fake corner.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Lee out in front.
Oh, Lee, huge lead.
Oh, look at me. Look at me go.
Oh, we're coming down the stretch. That was quick. Oh, wait. Okay, sorry. We got multiple cameras here. I'm very confused.
Whoa. Come on. I can do this.
Oh, here comes Trey.
Come on, Trey.
Come on,
Trey.
Here it comes. Easy.
Hey. What a dick.
What was that?
Who won?
Oh, my God.
Oh,
I have
Lee
to win.
Definitely won.
Who won?
Who won? Oh, we have a line and everything.
Oh, man.
Look at this technology.
It's like a first down line.
Oh, let's escape. Yeah. That's me. That's Skeets.
That's Lee.
That's J.E. Skates on that one.
No way.
Oh,
no,
come on. Here we go.
Here we go.
Yeah,
size,
this is me.
Perfect size.
You pulled him down.
Yeah, I know.
Cheap
look at that. He's celebrating. Skates wins.
I don't know.
What's up, starters? I love it, baby. I love the race for the cup. I don't know if it's the Canadian Cup, the NBA TV Cup, but it's some cup. I just want to say this. Lee, way to skate through the tape. I love how you looked over, and because you were showing off, unlike Kenny, you kept running. Kenny was showing off and looking back. You were showing off, and then you slipped. The skate came up. Way to skate through the tape, baby. Way to win the NBA Cup, or the NBA on TNT Cup, or the NBA.com Cup, or the Canadian Cup, eh? Good job.
I'm Matt Wilson. You're at Battle, the Backyard Axe Throwing League, and I'm going to teach these guys how to throw some axes today. Here's how it works. We got a bullseye, black ring worth 5 points, red ring, middle ring worth 3 points. This outer ring is worth 1 point.
That guy just looks like he throws a lot of axes,
yeah.
Right?
Oh,
all
yeah.
Right, so Tass up first. We'll play a couple rounds here, three rounds.
Yeah.
Almost stuck it.
Now, it took a while to get used to it.
Yeah. We couldn't get it to a flow.
You can't do the wizard, he said. You got to follow through.
You got to be
a swan.
So 0 for 3. This guy looks like he's throwing an axe.
Bang! Oh.
So Trey leading after round one.
Yeah.
Trey up 3 points. Tass, second shot.
I don't
shot.
Think Trey practiced.
Oh, nothing there. Okay. What do I got?
All right, what do you got?
What
here?
Do I got? Come on, follow through, Skeets.
Oh yeah.
Oh, yeah. Celebration.
Huge.
Lee with the plaid and everything.
Whoa.
Coming back. Hot axe. Trey. I'm leading at the end of two here. 5-3, round
Not
three.
Bad.
The ultimate throw.
Buried it.
I need that.
You look swanish.
Oh, it's the, the chalk
It's line. the LeBron.
Oh.
I went for the glory.
Yeah, those green dots are worth 7. Trey needs this to win. He got it.
Oh, wow.
Trey Kirby takes it. I believe 8-5. Look at this guy.
Yeah.
So whoever finishes a plate of poutine first.
Please bring those in.
Yeah.
We'll win this Canada Cup. Well, let's touch forks. Best of luck.
I'm eating this like giving it a little respect like the delicacy poutine is.
Okay, first to finish. Let's do this in 3, 2, 1,
good luck, everybody.
I'm like Kobayashi.
Oh, man. Oh, gross.
If we get hospitalized, the good thing is we have Canadian health care.
Speak for yourself.
I'm getting close to puke.
You guys want some water?
Get on my face!
If you puke, right, you win.
The gravy is really.
Oh, Tass is gonna do it.
Oh my goodness.
You've had some success when it comes to trading. First off, you've won an Executive of the Year back in 2013. And I would say you've made a lot of trades, and I think more times than not, you've come out on top. But we want to put you to the test here on the starters. We're going to play Let's Make a Trade.
Wow.
Okay? So the first one.
Okay.
You have a bottle of water there. You've had a sip from that bottle of water.
Yes. We've been watching.
We, the starters, would like to trade you this empty roll-up-the-rim Tim Hortons cup for that bottle of water.
Okay.
Now,
potential to win a
there's
lot
no
of
coffee in it, but you could win a Honda Civic.
Oh, wow.
So a straight-up trade here. No donuts
maybe
to be named later or anything like
maybe
that.
Maybe a coffee.
Hey, we don't know. You could win nothing. Do you want this cup for that bottle of water?
I'll keep my water.
Wow!
He knows the percentages.
Let's take a look.
Roll
here.
That rim.
Please play again. Okay,
yes.
Never mind. One for one. Okay.
That's why he's GM of the year, man.
All right. This one. This one's going to be a little more interesting here.
Okay.
We would like to offer you, in a trade,
yes,
straight up, this signed starters t-shirt. Okay.
Whoa. Is that signed by you guys?
Yeah, it's not Barkley and Shaq here. This is us, unfortunately. For your very cool blazer. A shirt signed by the starters for your very cool blazer.
You can hang
cool
this
blazer
in the new war room, maybe.
Wow.
Oh.
Wow, pass it over. Let's make that deal happen. Put it on, Trey. Taz, put it on somebody.
No, this must be an expensive jacket.
Wow, look at this. What a deal.
Wow, smell fantastic.
Okay, yeah, here, look.
Oh, yeah,
get it in.
Wow.
This
feels great.
Oh, wow.
Oh, yeah, I'm a power player. I'm a power player.
You're better.
Looks good.
Oh, my God. All right, okay.
Yeah, startups, baby.
A great deal. We want to give you a little parting gift as well. You got the t-shirt. I believe we have a giant cutout version of Trey Kirby. We're going to give this to you. You can take that home. Do whatever you want with it.
I can take this home?
Yeah, that's right. But
that's
here's the thing. Here's the thing. Let's play one more round. We would like to offer you the real Trey Kirby for your cutout version of Trey Kirby that you just acquired.
I'll take this.
Oh, man.
I think he's 3 for 3.
3 for 3. A killer deal.
How
guys,
dare you?
Give it
how
up to the signing jury.
We're here at the Stan Sox Spades Tournament with our host, future Hall of Famer Dwayne Wade. Dwayne, you're a 12-time All-Star. You won an All-Star MVP. You hit a game winner in an All-Star game. You had a triple-double in an All-Star game. You've basically done it all. What is your favorite All-Star memory?
Oh, man, it would have to be my first All-Star. Just being a kid, wanting to play the game of basketball, wanting to play with some of the great game's greats. And I got an opportunity my second year in the league to be on an All-Star team. And it was amazing, man. So I remember that it was me and LeBron's first year. It was just a cool experience just to be around all those guys and actually play and be a part of us winning that game.
You didn't mention your skills challenge wins as your number one accomplishment. You were the first guy, though, to go back-to-back in the skills challenge, 06 and 07. Yeah. Where are you putting that on your list of all-time accomplishments? I'm guessing you got the trophies up by the finals MVP at home.
Well, I have it up. But it ain't about a finals MVP. I think I'm, one of two or three guys that's done it so far.
Yeah, super rare to be a two-time winner.
Yeah. So for me, it was cool. I still think if I got into today, I still think I'd do well.
All right.
I've been thinking about it, but
I don't know, man. I watched the 08 contest today. It looked like you were done defending.
I was. You know what? I was at that point where I had so many different things on my plate. I wanted to take one off, so I did.
You were a part of a big-time Kobe All-Star moment not too long ago. 2012, he goes baseline. You foul him, accidentally break his nose. Now, this is Kobe's final All-Star game. How do you plan to send him out?
I mean, he's a competitor. He's going to go for it, you know, and I'm just happy to be a part of it. So I didn't try to do that. Did not, you know, it was just flashbacks of playing that guy and just being competitive and it happened. But I've had so many moments with him in my 12 years in these All-Star games, so I'm glad I get another one.
One of the guys on our show, Tass, said you shouldn't be starting the All-Star game.
Yeah.
You called him out on Twitter.
I did.
Now you're here starting the All-Star game. If Tass was here right now, what would you say to him?
I wouldn't say nothing. You know, each is their own opinions. But, you know, our fans, you know, decide who the starters are. They decide who they want to see in the game, you know. So if you want to talk about production, if that was what we're going off of, I would pick other guys. You know, I would pick Jimmy Butler, who had a great individual year. So I understand everyone's arguments, but this game is about our fans. But I would be in the All-Star game. So it don't matter if I'm starting or not. I would be here, homie.
Yeah, the dude's a legend, no doubt. Good stuff. Dwayne, good luck tonight. Good luck Sunday in the All-Star game. Thanks for talking with me, man.
I appreciate it, Taco.
Thank you.
Coming up, dreams do come true. Lee gets advice from one of the league's best three-point shooters before taking a crack at the three-point contest himself. I'd watch that.
I scored 16 last year and I missed my last four. So it made me feel that
fatigue
for 20 was in reach.
Okay.
So I actually had to get one of the best shooters in the business to come and help me out and see if he could help me achieve 20, because that was my goal for this year.
Well, let's have a look.
The three-point contest is a difficult thing to do well in. You know, it really is. You warm up and then you kind of sit there for a long time and then you have a minute to make it happen. It's sometimes difficult to find your rhythm.
Do you think you can help me get to 20?
I hope so. 20 is a good number, man. It's a good goal.
It's a good goal, right. So I'm going to go around, just shoot a couple of shots. You can sort of have a look at how my form is, my mechanics, my footwork, my body, all that sort of stuff. And then when I knock a few in, hopefully, well, probably miss, but you can give me some advice and hopefully we can improve.
I love it. Let's do it. I think the shots that you missed were short. For me, when I shoot slow, I usually tend to leave them short.
Yeah.
Maybe try to pick up the speed a little bit.
Okay.
I think that might help you without rushing it.
See how we do from here, okay?
Cool.
Ready?
Do it. That's money ball. They were all money balls to me. I like that was the money ball rack. I like it. I liked it.
What do you think? Can I get 20?
I think you got 20 in you for sure. I think a big part of this contest doing well is actually practicing and getting used to the rack and things like that. That's a big deal. And I feel like you are well prepared and you're gonna practice and you're gonna do well. Good luck, buddy.
Thanks a lot, Kyle. Appreciate it, man.
You got it. You got
it. Great stuff.
You got it.
Here goes. 20. Kyle thinks I can do it. I think I can
21.
Do it too.
He's got 21.
21.
Come on.
All right. Hope so.
Let's
I'm rooting for
find
it.
Out Come on, how Lee. Close does in his third crack at the three-point contest. Can he hit 20? So this is your money ball
rack,
right?
This is my money ball rack, yeah. So they're obviously not the colored balls, but this is it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Started with the money ball rack.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's a great start.
Ooh.
I love how you're in
this is your
full
spot, Lee.
Uniform.
Yeah.
Look at those fans.
Oh, you
that's
felt great. That one, huh? That one felt good. That one felt good.
Okay. Oh, this is where things get deeper.
You do love the corners.
Oh, yeah, absolutely do. And this, actually, the left wing is my second favorite spot. So I want to get that money ball.
Wow.
That's a lot of money balls. 12.
Come on. But this is sort of what happened last year a little bit.
Oh,
it started
knock
high.
It down. Oh,
look at this.
And you usually can't shoot from here because this is where the game time desk is.
I know.
That's a tough one for you.
I like how you're cheering on.
Yourself.
Do you not
here
know?
Here we go.
No.
There we go. Really? There we go.
Come give on. Me another. I need that money ball.
Oh, it needs this.
Give me that.
No.
It's 14.
It's all right. It's done.
Perfect rack. Last year,
perfect
grab.
Perfect
grab.
Nope.
Oh, wet it.
Oh, 18. Come on.
16.
17.
19. Right 19.
Oh. 17. Oh, you're devastated and tired.
Just have a snooze.
Up next, it's the rubber match. Taco versus E-Dog, part 3. The weekend's real dunk contest, and the production value has gone way up. We'll be right back. I'm a traveling man, doing all that I can. Before we get to the dunks, I believe we have a tale of the tape. And we show this to you because, Trey, you've had a body transformation.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Under 200, baby.
Under 200. Lee's still a good 180.
Yeah, a healthy 180.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's get it
Tass and I are going to be voting on this. We got our scorecards here. But
get rid of that one.
We could have a tie, and the fans will be the ultimate tiebreaker. You need to vote live right now from dunk to dunk as we go on. Hashtag Trey Dunk if you want Trey, and hashtag Lee Dunk if you want, Lee.
You could decide whose trash talk we're going to hear for the next 12 months.
I don't know who we're starting with. Who has the first dunk?
I think it's me.
Is it Lee Lee?
It's me, yes.
Let's get to the dunks, man.
This one is called the Banana Slammer.
Oh, wow.
It's easily the healthiest dunk out there.
Okay.
You know I like my bananas, so I thought I'd combine my two loves, bananas and basketball, and go and throw down a dunk.
So what are you going to do?
Well,
I'm going to eat a banana while you dunk?
Well, I can't obviously eat the whole thing. I'm just going to take a big chomp out of it and throw down something that's about a, 360. Yeah.
Okay.
Look at that.
Look at that.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Are these going to get better?
Yeah,
so
of course.
I know where to start.
Look at that. You're trying to have a meal while throwing down a 360 one-handed.
A meal.
Yeah. I mean, look, there's not many dunks where you actually get a healthy...
That's a good point.
The banana slammer.
Yeah.
What are we on? Official 8-foot rims here? What are we
Those
doing?
Are officially 8 feet tall.
Yeah, okay. Decide. Eight or niner.
I'm going to start with the 7.
Wow.
I'm starting with the 7.
Okay, you influenced me. I'll go.
Well, a lot of people are worried about the cold up here in Toronto, so I thought I would warm things up with a little thing we call brrr. It's cold in here.
Inspired. The lumberjack.
The lumberjack, pure flannel, pure hat. We're tearing off a shirt. We're throwing it down.
Okay.
And look at that. That's a Trey Kirby Slam Dunk Championship t-shirt.
Wow, the props are
presumptuous, isn't it?
This is the year. No, Lee, this is more like calling your shot, to be honest with you.
I mean, you know. Like the pose.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, the dunk itself.
Get those in my web store.
I'm sticking with an 8.
I'm sticking with a seven. Lee, what do you got in store for your second dunk?
Well, you all remember D Brown in 1991.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to modernize it and call it the Dab Brown.
Okay.
And you're also
Do you know
remember,
what dabbing is?
Yeah, well, you're about to find out if I do or not. Remember, Trey was criticizing me because I was saying I was trying to pump shoes without pumps. Well, I got pumps that D Brown wore. And look at that. And there's the double dab. I mean,
you're the worst.
You might get a you're the worst score here.
Yeah, there is a you're the worst card in here, isn't
there? Listen, it's topical. Do you know what dabbing is?
Topical, Lee. Do you know what dabbing is? When you're talking about dabbing.
It's more like
the kids know.
More like the dad, bro. Real dad move.
The double dab.
Come on, Lee. I didn't like that one, Lee. I got to be honest. I'm going.
I got an 8.
I mean, there's 13er.
All right, Trey. Second.
Back in 1994, J.R. Ryder won the dunk contest with something called the East Bay Funk Dunk. I've never lived in the East Bay, but I did live here on Fleet Street. So this is the Fleet Street Funk Dunk.
Okay.
Pretty simple thing. Just through the legs.
That's nice.
And a dunk. This is a literal through the legs dunk that you're going to see. Do you think Lee Ellis can do that?
I love when the camera angle's so low to make it look like you're just skying there.
Look like I was skying. That's a lot of frame to get up that high.
It's a good dunk.
It was a better dunk than I'm giving you this. You're getting this round.
All right.
I'll give you a 9.
Wow.
What are the fans saying? This is called the Superman Down Under. Now, I had to recruit my 3-year-old to help me out with this one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he loves wearing a Superman cape around the house, so I had to steal it off him.
Okay.
And you've probably seen this dunk before from Dwight Howard. So I actually try in this one as well to get a thrunk.
You're going
to thrunk it.
Okay.
Yeah, thanks to Lee Mabry for the help. Chicken sandwich.
Okay, yeah. That's his chicken sandwich. The cape came off.
There you go.
Let's see, this is the angle.
Yeah, watch this.
A thrunk?
Yeah. That's a thrunk. That's a legit thrunk. That's hard to do.
Did you kick the cameraman there?
That was a kick.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
What do you got?
I don't know if we should be advocating for thrunks.
Hey. Oh, do you know how hard it is to do a thrunk?
Yeah, I miss this one a lot. That's true.
I'm giving it an 8.
I'll give it a 9.
Trey, you got to beat 17.
Yeah, back when I dropped my first Fire Dunk mixtape, people were saying, you got to dunk your baby. But that's crazy.
No,
you can't,
let's dunk a baby.
You can't actually dunk
if
your
you
baby.
If you dunk a baby, you win.
But this one here is a shout out to my baby girl, Isla. It's the dad dunk. I took her baby carry. I brought it with. We're popping out. And we're throwing down a reverse. And wait. Put her back to bed.
Yeah, rock her. Give her a kiss.
Love
her. This is good. This is good. The pop.
Oh, one of a kind right here.
Oh, you just punched your baby.
Yeah, but it was like on her butt, though, so it's okay.
Okay, I like
more like a gentle love tap, if you will.
I saw this live in my driveway.
A tenner!
Oh, wow. I love the creativity.
Wow. I'm going 9.
19.
What do you got?
You know, everyone's talking about the 20-year anniversary of the Bulls going 72-10, but it's also the 20-year anniversary of one of the greatest dunks we've ever seen from Bones.
Of course. That's what was in the briefcase. It's so obvious.
I had to dig deep. I had to go and ask Bones for his jacket because I know I needed something special. Shout out to Matty O there for coming in and helping out.
Hey, Matty O, smile a little
bit. Great accent.
This is serious stuff.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, it's legit,
a banana.
Man.
It's another banana.
I hope it's a dunk.
So, yeah, I mean. Oh.
So this is the actual jacket that Bones wore in the 96 dunk contest.
This is the one. This is the one. So, you know, I mean, it worked for Bones. I thought it has to work for me, too.
All right. It worked for one white guy. Yeah. It'll work for another one. All right. Where was the free throw line?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, look, you have to use your imagination a little on that, but look how far back that is. Look
at that. What are you talking about? We might as well put down the arbitrary line that I had from the skating
club. Look at this.
That's a seawalk.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
I know he did it after the three-point shootout, but I had to add my little line spice
like
to it.
David Brent.
Look at these leg moves.
Oh, my God.
I don't know. You got,
oh, no.
Yeah, listen. You did a lot of work. You did a lot of work for that
You're the weirdest guy. You're the weirdest guy. I know.
To be honest with you, though, I do think I'm going to win it because of this one. We came to Toronto. You can't come to Toronto without honoring the greatest dunker of all time, Vince Carter. This, my friends, is a dunk I call Vinsanity. We're going to pop off that gorgeous
nice
jacket.
Wow.
And wow, what's underneath there? Whose jersey could that be? Is it Jorge Garbajosa? No.
Amir Johnson?
Is it Amir Johnson? No. Is it Anthony Bennett? No. You'll see who it is. It's Vince Carter because I'm hitting the reverse 360.
Yeah.
On my very first attempt.
Oh, wow. Just like Vince.
Just like Vince. Oh, yeah.
That's a nice dunk. I like that dunk.
It's over. It's over.
Kirby really brought it this year. That, you know, dropping the 30 pounds, whatever you drop, you can really
that
see
helped.
It.
The rubber match.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Has been decided.
I'm giving it to Kirby. Let's give it up.
A perfect score.
Hey, the fans are saying otherwise.
The fans are saying otherwise.
They've been wrong before.
That's
why we don't let them vote.
Do we have a trophy? I believe we have a, yes,
Kelsey. Back to back.
It's ironic you said this is like Neek and Jordan in 88. I feel like Neek. I feel like I was robbed.
No, don't worry. Hey, Lee, stick the three-point shooting. Congrats.
One more break, but on the other side, we'll let you know what we have coming this week, including something very special on NBA Trade Deadline Day.
All right, that is officially it for the starters from Toronto All-Star Weekend. We had a blast thanks to all the fans that came out to any of our live shows. We got to get back, though, to Atlanta because the second half of the season officially starts now, Tess.
Yeah, and the NBA Trade Deadline Day is upon us on Thursday, a special hour-long edition of the starters, 6 p.m. Eastern. Thanks for joining us, folks. And remember, Toronto is such an amazing city. Even if it was minus 50 outside, it can't be stopped.
Embrace the night, people. Jeez, let me say embrace the night, at least. Oh.